hard work it is to really get yourself out there. So I decided to start something here for the community, okay? I'm a community board member. I'm also the president of the resident association next door. And I felt like, you know, instead of making another bodega or another barbershop, why not do something that's culturally exciting for kids? Because a lot of the kids, they look at basketball or hip hop or something like that, and they're not realizing that the artists are not just the ones that we see in the museums. It's also, we are living artists, you know? And so I felt like, why not create something where we could turn around and teach them how to start a whole project from scratch? And I mean, like, starting, like, taking your stretcher and stretching it out with the canvas and your boards and putting gesso on it, and that whole system where a lot of people don't see it. They always see the paintings that are on there, but they don't see the struggle of what artists actually do. So that's something that in the future I'm hoping to incorporate inside here as well. You know, what I've been doing is also opening the space not only for myself, but other Bronx artists. The small room we have in the back, we also have work from artists from Atlanta, Georgia. The smaller room inside there is a Bronx native artist as well. And so I felt like, you know, it's a good opportunity for everybody to be able to see something new inside this community, because it's changing so much. Every day is something new, and I thought it would be something to do. I mean, we've been here for about a year and a half, quietly. And I say quietly because I think it was, I don't really see the need to really yell. I think art is about the appreciation, and I love the fact that people have been trickling in throughout the few months that we've been here, and it's that surprise element that I love the most. A lot of people, when you go by, it's like totally by chance, yeah. And you know, and the thing about it is that when they come in, it's like a world difference, you know. And so one of the things that I want to add is that when I first started here, it was completely gutted out, and my kids and my brother-in-law, we all kind of chipped in. So what you see in here is actually a creation of myself, a vision that I kind of had, you know. One of the things I realized is that as an artist, I knew I could paint it, but if I could paint it, why can't I build it? And when you look at the old masters, you look at them and you realize that they weren't just known for their art. They were known for their inventions. They were known for their poetry. They were known for all types of different mediums. And that's what a real master is considered to be, right? Sometimes I stand over here on the other end helping people with their shirts and stuff like that. And when I look over here, I'm proud because it's something that I was able to create from nothing, you know? And I want to share that with my kids. You know, I want them to understand that anything that you want to do is possible. So, you know, you just have to believe in yourself. So, I mean, I don't know what else to say to you guys, but I want to say thank you guys all for coming over here. Is there any questions? If I could help you with, I definitely will try. What I will say, how about this? Here, what you're looking at here is my own exhibit, which is an exhibit I call Bereshit, okay? So if you guys follow me over this way, I'll kind of talk you through it. So Bereshit is actually a word that's found in the Bible, and it's actually a Hebrew word that means three words in one, which means in the beginning. So I felt like, you know, since this is the beginning of the art gallery, I wanted to kind of give homage to God, because if it were about him, I wouldn't have has the honor to be here. So what you're looking at is my rendition of God's creation of earth. So on day one, he said, let there be light, and it was. On the second day, he created the heavens and the earth. On the third day, he created the sea and the land. On the fourth day, according to the Bible, he created the four seasons, which is winter, spring, summer, and fall. On the fifth day, he created the whales, the fishes, and the birds. And on the sixth day, he created man and gave him dominion over the land and over the animals. So on the seventh day, according to the Bible, it says that he rested. So that's why there's no seventh painting. A lot of people come and ask me, hey, what happened to Eve? Well, according to the story, she comes a little later, so that's why she's not depicted here. So the next interesting thing is that I wanted, because of the size of the frames, I wanted to do all of the artwork in oils, but it's been so long since I actually worked with oils, so a lot of my material was kind of not up to par. So it's funny how intentionally and not intentionally, it actually worked out where it's going from dark, as you can see, dark, and then it goes into your colors and it blends in, and then you go into your blues and your ocean, and then it goes into your river and it flows right out. So that's something that I kind of said that it wasn't intentionally, but it did come out pretty well, if I do say so myself. Now, some of these pieces, just so you know, they're actually not entirely finished. When I did the grand opening, I was trying to rush to try to have everything open. So you can see here where it actually started dripping once we put it up. And definitely, they all need so much details. I really want to incorporate so much more. I just haven't had the chance, but I hope in the near future I will. So, any other questions?
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah.